The Internet Protocol Suite tries to deliver packets across the network, and it delivers packets from a source address to a destination address. So the natural next question is, what is an IP address? An IP address is an Internet Protocol address. It's a protocol address that's used, it's an address that's used by the Internet Protocol to identify computers that are connected to the Internet. Because when I'm transmitting a packet of data, if I don't know where it's trying to go, then it's going to be impossible to get it there. So if we review the fields of the IP packet header, remember that there's a source IP address, that's where the packet originated, and there's a destination IP address, that's where the packet's trying to go. And both of those, if you look at this helpful diagram, are 32 bits. So there are 4 billion possible IP addresses, and there's problems with how those are allocated that I won't talk about now, but the source and IP address are both 32 bits. So if you want to find out your own computer's IP address, you can do this interesting thing, which is you can go to Google, and you can Google, what is my IP address? And Google will tell you what your public IP address is. And so this is a public IP address of the computer I'm using for this presentation. You typically see IP addresses formatted in what's called dotted decimal notation. So there's a number followed by a dot, followed by a number, followed by another dot, four numbers separated by dots. Each one of those numbers can range from 0 to 255. Each one of those numbers is 8 bits of the 32-bit IP address field. So here's my public IP address. It's 128.205.39.97. And there is structure to these addresses. In a lot of cases, you can actually replace the names that you're used to using on the internet with IP addresses, and things will just work. So for example, I'm going to go over here, and rather than putting let me try to zoom this in. Oh, it's hard to do. Rather than putting a name into the address bar, I'm going to put a number. I'm going to put 128.205. I'll write it down here. 128.205.32.53. So maybe you've done this before, maybe you haven't, but I can just put an IP address into my browser window, hit return, check it out. I'm at our department's homepage. So www.cse.buffalo.edu is somehow the same thing to my web browser as 128.205.32.53. The other thing I want to point out, since we're talking about IP addresses, is some of the structure inherent to IP addresses. So this is the address 128.205.32.53. That's the address of the department homepage. Here's my public IP address, 128.205.39.97. And so it's interesting that this part of the IP address for my computer, which is located at the University of Buffalo, is the same as, and I'm actually also in the computer science department, it's the same as the IP address for the server that runs our web page. And this is not an accident. So these addresses are used to identify computers on the internet. They're used to ensure, so when I'm communicating with this particular website, I'm transmitting packets to 128.205.32.53, and the computer called 128.205.32.53 is sending responses back to my computer, whose public address is 128.205.39.97. So these are IP addresses that are used on the internet to identify all the computers that are connected to this huge computer network.